All right, welcome back to another episode of Fresh Off the Vine, where do we do blind tasting so you can go into the store prepared.
Once again, David Lachlan, your host for the show, and we're going to be reviewing two different Merlots today. So still after our selection the other day at Dan Murphy's, we've picked up one Merlot called the Devil's Creek. Now, not exactly sure where it's from, but... In this selection of finding this Merlot, I don't drink too much Merlot. We weren't really sure what to do. It was about 10 bucks for the bottle. And we don't normally read the back on the show. I don't think the back's more
marketing. Today's an exception, though.
Today's an exception because the back actually sold this wine for us. So, the Devil's Creek Merlot. Soft, velvety, lush, and deliciously naughty. Who knows, a few glasses of Devil's Creek may bring out the devil in you. Or you.
That's actually what sold us. We I don't know a whole lot about Merlot. I feel like the Merlot in many cases like the middle child.
It gets forgotten. Son. I don't know much about Merlot. I know a lot about being naughty. So I felt like this might be the perfect glass for me.
Okay, so the other Merlot that we are comparing today is one that we sourced from an online retailer, Oak Road Estate. It is called the Picker's Hut Merlot.
And this is the one with sort of one of the best reviews at the company and was at an exceptional price. I think we paid about
$8.90 a bottle or something.
$10.75, $1.29 for the dozen online. So exceptional. So very similar price point, and we'll be curious to see the quality. I know the retail price of this one in Dan Murphy's was about $30 or $33. Mm. I don't know, something like that. But the price isn't always an indication of wine. We're going to do a tasting and tell you honestly.
All right. You know the rules. Spit, swish, swallow. Then we give you a grape score.
Between 1 and 10, always on the hunt for that full bunch.
And if it lives under the hunt...
it'll be getting a cactus, prickly.
Okay. Cheers.
Cheers. All right. So immediately, before I sip it... sorry to steer off topic, but you're getting some sort of some quite stunning real purple hues. It's not looking too light, too thin. You're still getting what looks like, in terms of the color palette and visually, on the nose, you're still getting a nice depth of flavor.
So definitely. Just through the nose, as Locke said, on the nose. You're getting those nice vanilla, black currant, cherry notes.
Mm. Okay. Beautiful light beautiful light berry fruit flavors. You're getting raspberry, a bit, and then the flavor sort of gets a bit darker. Mm-hmm. So some black currant, some plum, and then I think a bit of vanilla to finish it off.
Yeah, definitely those vanilla notes really come through. It's got a really nice sweetness to it, but it's not overbearing.
Refined.
So I think this is perfect for a new drinker of wine,
mm-hmm.
who doesn't want to go for the really full body Shiraz.
Yeah, if you're not looking for something
nice to sweet that has that little sweetness to it, I think that's really nice.
That's a stunning everyday drinker. If you're only a Merlot drinker,
this is going to be the one for you.
You'll be very happy to just crack a bottle of that. I mean. From 11 o'clock in the morning, because it does, it has that perfect refined flavor, and it's not too it's not too much of a punch in the face, just nice and smooth, leaves you wanting the next sip.
And then going down the throat on the sip there, it's not thin. You get that nice covering of the throat, it goes down really nice. That's a nice Merlot.
That's a good quality Merlot, and very classic of Peter Lehman in the Barossa Valley, so I think it's a testament to the region it comes from. So yeah, very classic sort of Barossa drinking Merlot. So shall we rate the wine?
What are you thinking?
I'm going to give this, because I'm not a big Merlot drinker, I'm going to give this a 7. Because if I was a Merlot drinker, I'd probably be rating this a 9.
Mm,
but that's a 7 in my books, and I'm pretty much a Shiraz and Cab Sauv man quite classically. But yeah, that's a beautiful wine. And you'd have, I don't think you could open that at a table of wine drinkers and have someone say a bad word.
I think Merlot drinkers typically do look for those kind of sweeter vanilla notes. So if that was for a class of Merlot drinkers, I think they'd really fall in love with that. I'm going to go similar luck. I'm going to go 7.
Beautiful. Cheers.
Cheers.
One more sip at a picker's hut. It's fair to say that we picked ourselves a winner with the picker's hut today.
We're going to, as every episode, we're going to show a bit about the office and what we do here. We're going to cut to a little chat we had with one of our worker associates, Joel. Here you go.
We do a gog about every day.
Yeah, maybe skip over this part.
Joel.
Yeah.
Let's talk.
We need some light, bro.
There we go. What wine do you... You're a wine man, Joel. What do you usually go for?
Yeah, so the wine that I usually go for, just to have a dabble and a tickle as well, it depends if it's an everyday drinker or if I'm doing something special as well. Look, the one I went for a very, very special occasion was the Maddox Flat. Absolutely stunning. Hit the back of your throat, really gutsy. It's the one you can actually feel going down your throat and sitting in your stomach and going, wow. I can't wait to go back for another sip.
I thought you
keep saying this sitting in your stomach. Does it really sit in your stomach?
Yeah, it just...
How much does it sit in your stomach?
Like, seriously, it feels like I've eaten the bottle itself.
Does it?
Yeah, like...
It's a strange tasting wine.
It's not, not the taste, it's just the sip factor.
Fuck. All right. Oh my god. Jeez, the characters.
We're back. I hope you enjoyed our little chat with Joel. Now we're diving straight into the deep end with the Devil's Creek Merlot.
So the Devil's Creek was the one with the raunchy name, a little bit provocative. I'm not sure if they've used similar sort of marketing tactics as the 19 Crimes, something a bit provocative.
Bit edgy.
Especially to sort of bring the younger crowd in. I know if you were looking for a date night, if you were pretty eager beaver, and you read the back saying that this is going to make him or her a bit naughty after a couple of drinks, then you'd think the $10 is a worthwhile investment. So, I mean...
Definitely. Yeah. Definitely. And I mean...
It's nice packaging. It's got.
Just looking at the packaging, it's got that nice red on it.
What award does it have?
It has a. It's not an award. It's a major corporate sponsor.
And so they've got a gold sponsorship that looks like an award.
Looks like an award.
And it fooled me almost. So we'll see how it compares to the Picker's Hut, the Peter Lear and Barossa Valley wine.
So that's the Devil's Creek. No award. Official sponsor.
Yeah, so we'll just see, because that pick is hard for me. I couldn't find myself sort of enjoying a Merlot more than that. So I'll be really curious to see how that Devil's Corner goes. Alright, so initially on the palate, I'll put the sunnies down a little bit. It's not looking... It's looking pretty dark, actually. Which is a good sign.
We'll give you a look here.
It's not as light as I was sort of expecting for the cheaper Merlot. Some nice purple hues to it, a little bit, maybe a little bit lighter in colour than the Picker's Hut. But yeah, I think it looks on the
initial nose, it's not as soft and inviting as the Picker's Hut Merlot.
I was gonna say the initial nose, it's quite acidic. Which is not what you look for in a wine, so I'll see if I can be swayed. But
the Devil's Creek. Let's jump in.
Let's jump.
Alright, you know the rules. Spit, swish, swallow, then we're gonna give it a grape score.
Between 1 and 10 on the hunt for that full bunch. Let's see how it goes. Cheers. Let's hope this isn't a cactus.
All right. We're laughing just because
it tastes horrible. I'm laughing because the flavor's atrocious. I'm not a very harsh reviewer, as I say before every review I do, but I'm a fair reviewer. Okay, so that tastes like a combination between port and red cordial. And when I'm drinking for my Merlot 2019 vintage, I'm definitely not looking for the flavor of port. And the next thing I'm not looking for is the sweetness of like someone just poured a bit of maple syrup in it.
Yeah.
I don't know. That
it almost tastes like the type of red wine that I know hangovers usually kind of come on the next morning. This looks like something that might come on in 10 minutes.
Yeah, I've from the initial nose, that's why I'll sip that very slowly, because just on the nose, like it smelled horrible, it tasted horrible, and that's something that I could have cooked up in my bathtub.
I'm going to give it one more sip, just to give it the benefit of the doubt here. We're honest reviews. Give it one more sip.
I will give it one more sip, but I mean, like I said, I'm not a big Merlot drinker, and I don't even think this is a Merlot.
It is an extremely sweet wine.
You know what?
One of the sweeter wines I've ever
that's
tried.
That's so sweet. Oh, you know, I had flashbacks to my 14-year-old self standing in a park with David, actually. We've known each other for a very long time. With David in our younger years, me on like my hands and knees, David with the
goonbag
dripping down my chin, and then quite close to the sip, the dry reach, holding it in and then feeling horrible. If you want to revisit your 14-year-old self, drink the Devil's Corner.
If you took that on a first date, you might not be getting replied to for a while. You might be getting left out in the lurch, because that's not impressing anyone.
That's not if anything, that would be a game changer for me. I wouldn't associate with someone drinking that wine.
I'd have to ghost the person if they brought that to a... Especially if they brought that... Someone brought that to my 21st birthday party.
I'd more like... I would sooner crack that bottom on their head than share a glass with them. Because that's horrible. So, I think I'm going to be... Step up with the review here.
The Devil's Creek.
The Devil's Creek is the first cactus on the show. That is a...
Wow.
That is a cactus out of a grape. That's a sour grape. And...
The cactus.
So, it just shows...
I think I might follow suit.
Are you going to cactus it as well?
I'm going to give the Devil's Creek the first ever cactus.
And that's quite exciting for us, actually, because we didn't think we'd run into... Because I wasn't thinking we'd have anything cactus.
We didn't think we'd have a cactus so early on, which is interesting.
I'm not going to keep talking down the wine.
Let's not keep talking down the wine.
I won't. Let's just say I'll never, ever be drinking that again.
No one knows what's happening.
That's something that you'd find your 12-year-old brother drinking at your 18th birthday party. That he's, I don't know, that he's found on grandma's expired cellar. I would not be recommending that to even an enemy of mine. And there is plenty. So I would be...
Okay.
Not even my worst enemies, I would recommend the Devil's Creek. So yep.
So that's it for the for Merlot.
So we've got the Pinkest Hut sitting at a solid 7.
Let's take them, let's do the rose. Okay.
Okay, so we've got the Pinkest Hut at a solid 7, and we've got
the Devil's Creek
cactus.
Is a cactus today.
That is a sour grape. Now, the Pinkest Hut, we paid $10.75 for a dozen with free delivery.
And where'd you buy it? What online shop?
Okra Estate. So, I mean, without any bias here, that is a cactus.
The Devil's Creek, we purchased at Dan Murphy's, recommended by the store runner, Dan.
Yeah, but that was actually the one recommend the floor manager
so
gave
us. Just the floor manager who recommended that for us.
I don't know.
You can sit on a cactus yourself.
yeah, dead set. I don't know what that guy was trying to do, if he was trying to poison us, or if he's palates the one of Helen Keller, blind, dumb, and deaf. So, thank you.
Thank you very much, guys. Stay tuned. Fresh off the vine. We're going to pick some more grapes tomorrow.